Hi everyone, it's Melody with Design by Melody. I'm here with another layout for Stash Kit Saturday, and I, of course, want to apologize for my very croaky and froggy voice. I still have allergy problems, as I've been having for like the last month, but I'm working through them. So this is a really fun and bright layout, but what I started with were my photos, my journaling, and these three journaling cards in the middle. So because I had four small photos, I wanted to do a bit of a grid, a bit of a grid design on this 12x12 layout. And so I put out these journaling cards from what I had in the kit. I believe they were from a Me My Big Ideas pack. I think that's what those were because they're bright colors. And then on the back, I think are just grids. So I think that's from a Me and My Big Ideas little pack of cards that I had pulled. But I wanted to do my journaling because I wanted to do these strips. As you could see, I kind of thought this out and planned it out and had put little strips right there above the photos on the right and below the photos on the left. So it's going to look like this for a little bit, but my journaling was just too long. It was a lot longer than what I had originally expected it to be. As you can see, I keep writing it out, trying to figure out what I'm going to say. So I'm going to eventually change and type up my printing. Or not my printing, my journaling. So what my journaling says is Kaylin has a very keen sense of self. He knows exactly what he likes and doesn't like so much. His hair is such a distinctive part of his body, and as soon as he gets a haircut, you know he likes it because his whole attitude changes. It's so special to see his own confident and grown-up self. And isn't that the truth? My child will be all playful and everything, and then as soon as he finishes with that haircut, he turns into like Mr. Cool. and then of course he likes to have, he's in a faux hawk stage where he likes the faux hawk and then has like the designs in his hair on the side. And it looks really cute on him, especially with his curly hair, because it can be closer on the sides but curly on top, and it's really cute that the way it looks. So I'm still kind of playing around with the handwritten journaling, but I'm just not going to like it. It's too many lines, and with the printed journaling, I can kind of reduce the number of lines. So I'm going to go back and do that in a moment. But I'm pulling out all my supplies for my stash kit first so that I can kind of figure out what I'm doing. I don't even know what my background paper is going to be at this point. I just know that I want my photos in a grid pattern with these journaling cards in the middle, and then that blue triangular journaling card is going to hold my title. But I have to figure out what my background paper is going to be. So I'm pulling out all the background papers from the kit. And as you can see, I have a lot of these green colors left. I have this pink. I like that ledger, that notebook paper, but it won't work for this kit or for this layout. It needs to work with something that's going to be a little bit more of a story where I have a long journaling. I love that paper, but I just haven't been able to find something to work with it yet. So I go back and forth between a couple of the different papers, and I settle on this darker lime green colored paper here for the background, and it's very bold. And with the red and the teal and the black and the white, all the colors really pop off of this paper. Now I have all my scraps laid out here to the side to see if there's anything that I end up wanting to use. But as you can see, this paper is actually from Webster's Pages. I believe it's their Clean and Simple line or collection that they had. But it's going to be my background. Just going to trim off the manufacturer strip so I have my full 12x12 sheet here. And then I'm going to go ahead and trim out all my photos. Now they are roughly like 2¾ by 1¾, basically. No. Roughly 2x3. I think they're roughly 2x3, but I'm cutting them down, whatever. Whatever they were originally, I'm cutting them down. To make them a little bit more square. And I'm also trying to center Kaylin in the middle of them as I trim them. As you can see, I'm just taking a little bit more off. I like the white border on my photos though, so I will end up adding them to some white cardstock as a background. I had to measure my photos right after I did that to make sure. And then I'm going to trim down this old shoot to go right in the center of that red one. Kind of just to create a little bit of a decorative grid right here in the middle. And then I keep all my little scraps of the paper, but I will throw away all the extra pieces of my photos that I cut out. This one actually took me quite some time to put together, and I think it's because it's got a lot of little pieces on it. There's a lot of different elements. It's not that I'm just throwing photos right down onto the layout. I'm actually cutting them out and trimming them and making a grid and all of that. And then I do have a lot going on in the background. It's small embellishments, but I do have a lot. And then I'm at the point with this kit. This is my stash kit. I think this is the 12th layout. I'm pretty sure this is the 12th layout. I'm at the point with this kit though where I'm starting to feel like I don't have enough to work with. And I think this might end up being my last layout. I don't know how you guys are, but when I'm with a kit, I can work for a really long time with it, especially while I still have papers. But I do reach a point where I just feel like I don't have enough to work with, and that's how this was. I just felt like I didn't have enough die cuts, or I have a lot of stickers and labels, but just not a lot of decorative items to work with. I have a lot of more like office supply stuff. Type things, labels and tags, and of course I have all my cards. I had a billion cards, and I don't think I did a single, maybe I did, but I don't think I did a single Project Life layout with this kit. I've been working with my Project Life kits. My Kit Day Thursday kits have been primarily Project Life focused, or like pocket card focused kits, so I really haven't had enough photos to do any Project Life spreads. I have a lot of 12 by 12 layouts to do, or just single photos to scrapbook. So there just hasn't been much of a need for me to do Project Life photos or layouts with the stash kit. So I want to create a little bit of a border at the bottom. It just was looking kind of plain or something. And so I had this journaling strip here that just had the like kind of a painted line at the bottom. And I wanted to leave a little bit of green underneath of it. Just to show, I didn't want it to be a true border at the very, very bottom, but I wanted it to be a little bit of a division between, or a little bit of a definition to the bottom of the layout. Now, nothing is adhered down except for this manufacturer strip, and I'm going to end up pulling that off because I don't like the way that it looks. And I'm going to end up just using that ribbon that I just cut, and it's a chevron type ribbon, so it's got the triangular pattern on there. Or arrowhead type pattern on there. So I cut the ribbon to go along with that pattern. So it's got like an arrowhead on one end and a tail on the other end, or a flagged banner tail on the other end. And I like the way that it looks. I have a lot of space, I guess, on this layout. Like there's space between my photos, there's space between my journaling lines, and that border at the bottom with the manufacturer strip was just too much for me. It needed space around it. I felt like going all the way to the edges just made it too much, and it will come off. It just has not come off yet. And I'm trying to figure out my title, and I'm going to go through a ton of alphas here trying to figure out which alpha I want to use. So I already knew that my title was going to be A Style All His Own, but I wasn't exactly sure which alpha I wanted to use. I thought I wanted to use a small one, but this is actually too small for this journaling card, so it is a little bit of a longer title, and it needs to be an alpha that's going to fit. Like thickers aren't going to fit. However, having the tile letters were just too small. It doesn't make as much of an impact on this little journaling card like I want it to. And this is where I'm thinking about it. This is an October afternoon daily flash alpha. I'm debating. I said, okay, well, let me just try. And of course, I'm going to write out the whole thing. And then I'm going to be like, nope, too much. It's too little. It just doesn't work. It's too little. So I will take this off and change it. I suppose I could have made that work if I had decorated around it, but nope, I don't like it, and I immediately take it back off. Now, I thought about taking this part out, but I feel like it's something that is part of my process, and if you truly like process videos to see how things come together, then this is something that you might like to see. Me try or audition different alphabets to see what fits. I believe, yes, here we go. This is my total. This is my final alpha. Now I'm going to cut out part of this because I truly fuss with this alpha. So I love these Daily Flash October afternoon alphas, but as you'll notice right here, the L is so tall that I have to like make my letters kind of go down in order to fit it. So I have to trim off the L. And then also that Y hangs down so much that it almost doesn't leave enough room for the next line. And then again, I have these L's that are just so crazy tall And then the H stands up extremely tall as well. So I had to fuss really a lot with the spacing here. And I'm going to continue to cut and move and shift and so on and so forth. I'm going to skip part of this though, because I literally fussed with this for about 10 minutes, which is quite some time. But you get the idea of what I did, and here we go. This is how it turns out. It says a style all his own, and I'm going to add an exclamation point here at the very end just to kind of fill in that little bit of space. So that is my title. I love it. I love how it's got a little bit of a different style itself with the script font. It just is a little bit different. It's not just a simple block font. It's something different, and it kind of goes along with the idea of the sense of style, which is what my layout's all about. Wow, my brain. I've taken so much allergy medication, I don't think my brain is properly functioning. I've also typed up my journaling, as you can see. I did that in between clips. So I've already cut it out. I've got it printed and everything. So that is the final journaling that is going to end up on this layout. I'm just using my ruler here. I'm not actually measuring anything, but I was using the ruler to line up the grid lines on my mat to my layout so I could make sure that the bottom row was all even. And then I just kind of eyeballed the spacing otherwise. And then I'm going to go ahead and also adhere down my journaling. And I'm just going to stagger my journaling lines. I purposely made some smaller or shorter than the others, and also made it to where I could kind of stagger them backwards and forwards. And I'm just using my Tombow Mono Multi-Glue my glue runner to adhere these down. I realize I go through a ton of glue each month, and I think last month I included it in my haul and my used up video, for what I had for the month, just to see kind of how much adhesive I go through, and I go through quite a bit. It's kind of crazy, but just the same, I do a lot of projects other than just my YouTube channel here. I do have an Etsy shop, and so I make a lot of different paper items on there, so I end up using a lot of adhesive just in general. So I just think it's kind of funny how much I use, but then again, it's kind of a productive feeling too, to see how much you use. And my goal is not necessarily to use up items, but just to be productive and get things in my scrapbook album. I'm going to use another little bit of this ribbon here at the top to be the grounding point for another cluster up here. It's not going to be a very big cluster, but it's just enough to add some color up here. Then I am going to do another cluster down here at the bottom. And then I'm going to have little bits scattered around my photos. So I have a cluster at the top left, a cluster at the bottom right, and then there's just going to be a couple little bits scattered elsewhere. As you can see, this layout is turning out to be extremely colorful, and I love it. There's blues and reds and the greens, and then of course the black and white colors as well. Now I'm going to flip through everything that's in my kit, and this is exactly where I realized, I don't have a whole lot. So I'm going to pull some things from my stash. I'm going to pull my LE Studio die cut boxes that I have. I have a couple of them. I'm also going to pull my blue and my aqua box. I have like a box where I keep all my blue and aqua die cuts, or just random little bits of pieces that don't belong or don't have a package that they're in. I keep them in little color sorted boxes, and I actually don't use those color sorted boxes very often because I'm usually working within a kit, either a stash kit or a kit that I've purchased. And so I don't actually use those color sorted boxes very much, but when I do use them, they come in extremely handy just in situations just like this where I am looking for things that match my color scheme here. And I've got this darker kind of aqua blue that I'm working with. So it's perfect to pull in that box and have those items right there at the ready whenever I am ready for them. Pulled off a couple of those puffy stickers from the LE Studio puffy sticker sheet, and then I am going to use this last and final clip from that K & Company Smash Clips pack. It says love in lime green, which I could have used. It worked with my color, but I end up layering a couple things on top of that, so I'm going to flip it over. Ooh, I'm going to flip it over and just use the back side of that. Going through all my sticker sheets here to see if there's anything else that I would like to add. And I am going to pull out this flare badge. Now this was supposed to be a tree, but I'm turning it on its side and using it more like an arrow. And I am going to kind of layer it up here at the top with that other layered, ribbon that is cut into an arrow type embellishment, so it kind of fits with the theme there. Now, this is my LA Studio boxes, or these are my LA Studio boxes. I have a couple of them. Actually, I have three, but these are just two. One has primarily Christmas themed items in it, so I keep it separate. But these are just all the different LA Studio labels and die cuts and miscellaneous things that I have. And I love the colors of these. They always have, LA Studio always has some really great, bright, colorful, but simple embellishments. And so that just works perfectly with what I need here. I'm going to play around with a couple of different things. Some of these are going to make it, some of these are not, but you're going to see it kind of evolve here. There was this Right Now label that I cut and I made into a banner. And then I also have this camera, which really fits nicely. It's just a little bit large. The scale of the camera is too large for my layout. I have a visitor here that is watching the video with me as I narrate. You want to say hello? No, he doesn't want to say hello, but he's listening. You could probably hear him breathing. All right. I have this So Good label here at the top that's going to be on the ribbon. He has allergy issues too, so he's quite congested. We spent a lot of time outside yesterday, and I am quite sunburned, right? I am really, really, really red. Just my shoulders and my back, because I was wearing like a tank top outside, and we were riding bikes and watching airplanes, well, attempting to watch airplanes at the airport. They were landing on the opposite side of the airport, so we didn't get to see a whole lot of them land, but we did have a picnic outside. And just enjoyed the wonderful weather that we've been having here in North Carolina. It's been quite warm. It's just kind of gone back and forth between being warm and being cool. But this last couple bit has been quite warm, and it's just been really nice, which is also why our allergies are so, have kicked up so much, because everything's blooming, of course. It's spring, and we are actually getting ready to go camping here shortly in Florida with my mother, which is going to be quite nice. You're going to see some pictures of that. Maybe I'll do a little bit of a vlog while we're down there. That would be kind of fun, but we'll see. I'm not sure. We're going to be with some family friends, and then, of course, my mother. So I'm not sure what all we'll be doing, but we'll be having fun, and there will definitely be photos from there that I will be scrapbooking. All right, you kind of saw me sort through that blue and aqua box. That's where that a couple things came from there, and that little starburst came from there. A lot of the things from that blue and aqua box are not going to end up making it on this layout, because I'm going to pull out a sticker sheet from, as you can see, I'm flipping through all my kind of used up items here. I'm going to pull out a sticker sheet from, where was that from? That was from Stampin' Up! Memories in the Making kit that I used a couple weeks ago. And there's a sticker sheet with that bright blue on it. It's got like a blue swirl kind of thing. And then it's also got some little offcuts from a black sticker, as you can see right there. It's got some little black leaf. Kind of reminds me of a wreath almost. Leaf patterns. And then also has a red ampersand, and those colors all fit really, really well with what I have going on this layout. So I'm going to use those on this layout just to add a little bit of embellishment around my photos and my clusters. This ampersand was just perfect. It has no meaning to me. Like, it's not, I'm not trying to say and something. It's just the color and the size of it fit really, really well with what I was looking for. And I'm just going to cut up this little swirly pattern. When I was working with the kit, I loved that pattern, but I didn't know how to use it. It was printed on a couple of the cards, but I didn't know how to use the sticker itself. And then I have this little heart, which does not go much with the color scheme of what I have going on, but I want to layer it down here at the bottom with the other heart that I have up. I had already taken it off of my layout, but I had put that puffy heart sticker on my layout, and I'm going to layer that with that pink outline of a heart down here at the bottom. I'm just fixing some of the little stickers that I had put down and rearranging, and then adding a couple little bits and pieces here. These are just the little tiny black offcut pieces I had of some stickers that were already on that sticker sheet. And I'm just making some little banners to peek out from behind my photos on top of those blue swirly pieces. And then this is going to use up this sticker sheet. There was like a scallop circle on there, but it had tried to use it multiple times, and so it just got misshaped and wasn't working quite right. So this is going to finish that. And then I do have this word strip that just says, I love your smile, and I'm going to cut it out into smaller little bits and pieces and layer it over here on the left side above my journaling, just to kind of mimic that journaling, but also to bring a little bit of that darker color here. I am so in love with how this layout turned out. I just think it's really cute. It's different. It's not the same style as what I've been doing. It's something different. And I like having the variation in my album. I actually was just putting in the layouts that I completed in March in my album yesterday and kind of flipping through. And it's just nice to see the variation in my albums, the different colors, the different styles, just different. And I really like it. I think it's nice, it's interesting, and I'm just really pleased with how it all kind of came together. Now, sorry, he's running back and forth. Now this is, I'm just fussing with a few last little bits, and then this is going to complete this layout. I don't have anything else really going on, just finishing this and trying to see if I need any more of these little black rhinestones around. Now this may end up being my last layout that I create with this stash kit. So if it is, it's been a joy to work with, but I can't wait to get into my next stash kit that I created. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you have a great day, and I hope you really enjoy your spring season and get your allergies under control if you're having problems like I am. All right, thank you guys. Have a great day. Bye.